Hey, how you doing?
How you doing, sir? Officer Baskin, sir, is at a police department. You're on audio and video recording. The reason for the stop, you were observed going 57 and a 40, and you were on your phone texting while you were doing that. That was at Euclid and Fruitville.
You don't need to point at me, officer.
I'm not pointing at you. I'm pointing in the direction where it was.
I'll just call the chief, officer.
Go right ahead, sir.
Can you I see your license? Right?
Yes, sir, I do. Can I see your license, registration, insurance, please?
You can do this?
Yes, sir. I'm sorry? I still have a job to do, sir.
Yeah, what's your name?
Officer Baskin, it's going to be on the citation. Can I see your insurance registration and your license, please?
Been in the department,
sir, can I have
How
your paperwork?
You been there?
7 years, sir. Can I see your registration, please?
No.
You're not going to give me your registration, sir?
You can arrest me?
I'm asking you if you're going to produce me with your registration.
I have it.
You want to have it on you?
Look, go call the chief of Congressional. Tell him how rude you've just been to me. Mm-hmm. Blame this video.
Okay.
Right. Then you call Marlon Brown. Then you call the mayor.
Okay.
We're not okay, darling. Tell him what to do.
Okay, sir. Are you refusing to produce your registration? I'm asking you if you have your registration.
You're making career decisions.
Okay,
why are
sir.
You doing this?
Sir, because you were speeding and you were texting.
Seriously? Where's your video?
All right. Hang tight.
Call the supervisor. I just spoke to your boss.
Okay.
That's not okay.
You want your paperwork?
Is it your Russian immigrant status that makes you talk to people like this?
10-4, 10-6.
Call the supervisor.
14 dispatch, can you have my supervisor respond, please?
Yeah. And then we'll see who goes.
Okay. You don't want your paperwork?
6142,
you don't have a warrant.
Sir, you're going to be issued a citation.
Everything you have to say. I'll wait for the supervisor.
You can wait for the supervisor, but I'm going to go through what I need to go through.
No, I'm not interested.
Right, you are going to be issued a citation.
This is the registration. Okay.
Well, you've been already issued a citation for that.
For what?
For failing to produce your registration.
This is
all right. You sir, you're going to be issued a citation 57 and a 40 for speeding. Your fine is 256. Information in the back. You're going to have an option to plead guilty. An option to plead not guilty and an option to take a safe driver's course. If you qualify for the course, it will reduce your fine and it will reduce your points. If you decide to go ahead and do that, just make sure you do it prior to submission of payment.
Do you know what he said about you? Do you want to hear what he said about you?
He could say all he wants about me. I got a job to do, sir.
Yeah. You know what he said about you?
If you fail to complete...
He's had you before like this. And he's going to have you again.
And that's fine.
It's not fine. What you're saying is fine.
Sir?
I'm a law-abiding citizen, and you're being bloody rude to me.
If you decide to go ahead and do the course, just make sure you do a prior to submission of payment, as they do require a certificate of completion. If you sign up for it, you must complete it. Otherwise, they will go ahead and suspend your license. You are going to be issued a citation for texting and driving. Okay? You are going
to
be issued a citation for texting and driving. Your fine is 116. Information in the back. You're going to have an option to plead guilty and an option to plead not guilty. You are going to be issued a citation for failure to provide your registration upon request. Your fine is 116. Information in the back.
You
can plead guilty or not guilty.
You're lying.
Green paper.
You're
green
lying.
Paper tells you
you
have 30 days to replay.
Why are you lying?
You have 30 days to reply.
Why are you lying?
Your payment options are on the green form.
Why are you lying?
Phone number on the bottom in case you have any questions.
Come.
When my supervisor comes, I'll wait for him with you if you like me to. Your citation is over here.
You
can accept them.
I will wait.
I will wait, but I will wait in my car.
Me,
there you go.
Yeah, but you have the bad thing.
Sir, step back into your car or stand on the sidewalk so you don't get hit by a vehicle. It's for your safety. 14 radio, can I have another unit respond?
Well, how's your hand picked up there?
Sir, stand over there. It's for my safety and for your safety. Sir? 10-4, the driver being extremely uncooperative.
10-4.
Yes, Arch.
6122 to 6715, are you anywhere close?
I can't. He won't let me leave until a supervisor shows up. Martin Hyde. I just gave him 3 tickets.
Okay.
Yes. Bye. Speeding 57 and a 40, texting while driving, and failure to produce his registration because he told me I could look it up. And he's gonna have my job. Everything is on camera. Alrighty. Bye. Are you still waiting for a supervisor, or are you leaving?
Randy Young is coming now.
Okay. Very good.
Oh, by the way, he's a friend of mine.
I'm sorry?
I'm aware of that situation.
Okay.
I'm on my way over there.
You know Pat Robertson, right?
Yes, I do, sir.
Why are you doing this?
Because I have a job to do, sir.
Oh, my God.
Nobody's above the law.
No one's above the law. You have to have some degree of respect for law-abiding
officials. That degree of respect started the moment I walked up to your car, sir.
No. You knew exactly what you were doing, and you made a mistake.
If that is your feeling, you are more than welcome to fight the citations in court.
I'll fight the citation.
Okay.
I'll fight your employer.
Okay. You're more than... You know, you're an influential person. You're...
Very.
You can go ahead and do that.
Yes, I can.
Okay.
Why don't you just say you're sorry?
Because I did nothing wrong, sir. I was doing my job. But I am going to ask you either to sit in your car or step on the sidewalk because I don't want either one of us getting hit. Okay. Sir, I have nothing more to say to you, sir. You're requesting my supervisor. You can have the conversation with them now. Sarge Frangione is on his way.
Okay.
Speeding 57 and a 40. Texting while driving, failure to produce his registration when I asked, he told me I could look it up.
Okay. You know who he is?
Yes.
Right? Yeah,
you've
identified him?
Yes.
Okay. So you're just going to stay by to cite him, or is that what you...
He already got cited.
Oh, he has already got the citation, so he just...
From the moment I woke up.
So he's just waiting for...
He's waiting for supervisor, and I guess he spoke to Frangione, so... Frangione is on his way.
Okay.
Bobby just pulled up.
Okay. Hello, Mr. Hyde. I guess you talked to Sergeant Frangione by the phone?
I did, yeah.
Okay, he's on his way. She requested another unit, so that's why another unit.
How do you give someone a certificate, a ticket for no registration when they've got their registration? She's trying to make her spurs, but it's a big mistake.
Well, this one is the expired one, but...
Well, it doesn't make it. It'll take 2 seconds.
Yeah.
We're going to make sure that she pays the price for being disrespectful. I just want you to witness and know that the registration was right there, and she deliberately chose to write the ticket. She came up,
but
she said, the first... Look, there's a video of it, so be quiet. There's a video of what you said.
There is.
And I've got a video of what you said. What she said was, I don't have it. She immediately said, I write your citation. She went right back. She never said anything. She went straight back. I denied the citation. She's straight back, write the citation. I've lived here for 25 years. I've represented your unit. I've got no interest in listening to you, young lady.
Yeah, just a second, officer.
Come on then.
Yeah, Mr. Hyde, like I said,
I've represented you guys in union discussions. My son is a cop. I'm friends with everybody in the police department. This is the first time anybody has been disrespectful to me. And for what reason? I could care less. If they were going to write me a ticket, I could care less. I just pay the bloody thing. You don't think I got the money?
Mm-hmm.
It's the manner and the nature of it.
Okay. And like I said, Sergeant Fangione will be over here to talk to you about her interaction.
Outrageous. Yeah. Why would you do that? Why? I mean, of all the people to do it to.
Yeah, I understand, sir. And, you know, I set you, you know, I've been with the negotiations with you, and I understand where you're coming from.
I don't ask for special treatment, but I don't expect to get treated like a punk.
Mm-hmm. Let me go talk to her and see.
Well, it's a waste of time. Yeah. She's got it in her head. I know exactly who she is. Grangione told me exactly who she is. That's fine. 7 years might not turn into weight.
No. He'll review it if he needs to review it. He can stop
because
it.
Sarge was already calling me to do that. He just didn't know that this is who he was.
Oh, okay.
So, but I couldn't leave until somebody was here, so just let me know what you need me to do.
Is Sergeant Frangione coming on his way here? Is that,
yes.
He is?
Yes, he called me. He was...
I just wait for him to get here and then... well, let me give him a call real quick. Because okay. that might help matters.
Want me here or anything?
No. No.
Proceed to the route.
Stay in your car.
I just want to know if you want me to go back to the station.
You can go to the station. Yep, go to the station. Hey, Martin.
You got that thing on?
Yeah, I have to leave it on.
Alright, so here's the thing. She lied about the cell phone thing.
Okay.
She lied about the, I don't know, the speed. I could care less. You can give me the ticket all day long. I could care less about that. And then I gave her the registration, and she, before, she says, oh, your registration? It's in the car there somewhere. She goes off, she writes me a ticket, she brings me back a citation. I said, there it is.
Okay.
And she still gives me it.
Okay. All right.
She's being fun. And the thing is, I appreciate that. I back you guys left, right, and centre.
I understand that. I do. I trust me, I do
and
know
I
that.
I don't expect better treatment, but I don't expect worse treatment. If that's how you treat people, that's unacceptable.
Okay. I understand. I understand your frustration.
And I can get the video and I can play it to I understand that, but you know, the thing is, I don't take kindly. She knew exactly, because I said to her, I said, you know, right away, I said, look. She's like, yeah, I know. Straight away, writing the tickets. Why?
Well, she's a traffic officer,
yeah,
that's what we do, but I understand.
Yeah, I understand that's what she do.
Yeah.
It's not what you do, and you know it.
Listen, she has a job to do. I'm going to look at the video. I understand your concerns. I'm going to look at the video. I notified everybody in the chain of command right now. That's what I was doing. That's why I was not coming here. I thought you were going to meet me at the station, but it's not a big deal. She's going right now to dock her video. Right now she's going to dock the video. And if there's problems, you will be the first to know.
Well, I know there's problems, but the difference is, I'll do something about it.
Okay, I understand. Yeah, I'm going to take your complaint, is what I'm doing. That's the first step.
You know, how can you write a ticket for no registration when you've got the registration? I mean, as if I got a $150,000 car, I've lived here for 25 years, and I don't register a car. Why do that?
Yeah, I understand what you're saying.
Well, you tell me what the point is.
It's just a state statute that she enforces. She's not the only traffic officer that writes.
Would you give a ticket for that?
I really don't leave the office. I understand what you're saying.
I understand you have a video on there, but the fact is nobody in their right mind would give a ticket for that to me. Nobody.
I understand what you're saying, and you producing it, she probably should have taken that ticket away, but I'm going to find out what exactly occurred.
Because
and that's
she had a beer in her bonnet because she thought she was on a big power trip. Guess what? She's been there 7 years. She ain't gonna make eight.
Okay.
I'll make sure.
Well, I'll get going on.
She ain't.
All right, listen, that's your prerogative. I'm gonna get
this
started.
This is not right, Emily.
Okay, I understand.
It's not right. You don't treat people that have treated and supported you like that.
I understand where you're coming from. I
do. Bare minimum of respect is yes, sir, no, sir. Not a word of it. Straight up. talking to me like I'm a piece of dirt. Get back in your car. Which is this? I'm, she stands, she's got a car door open, and I'm leaning against here talking to someone.
Okay.
Right? So, in case you get hit by traffic. Just being difficult. Okay. Right? Just being cocky.
I do understand where you're coming from.
But it isn't. It's a bad interaction.
Yeah. It definitely seemed like it was.
How difficult is it to come to me and say, you're doing 57, give us your license and your registration? Why get into immediately like that? When she knew exactly who she was talking to. If that's how, no wonder you got people shooting people in Newtown if that's how you talk to people.
Alright, Martin, I'll talk to you later.
And writing tickets when someone's actually got the physical stuff, you tell me that's good.
I understand. I do. Alright, I'll talk to you later. I'm going to go to mute.